warmest year ever, most snow ever, and a mega drought for the United States. But you know what, guys? Global warming isn't real. Hello, people who are ready to listen, and also climate trolls. Thank you for watching DNews. I'm Trace. Let me tell you a story about how global warming or climate change, if you prefer, is happening. It's science, it's proven, deal with it. But just because we know it's happening doesn't mean that we know the long-term effects. In light of conservative officials from the great state of Florida unofficially discouraging government and educational institutions from using the words climate change, global warming, or sea level rise, we thought we would see how that was working out for everybody. Luckily for us and for Florida, the Pacific Northwest National Laboratory analyzed data running back 2,000 years using ice core information and weather data from the 19th and 20th centuries. They projected temperature changes in 40-year chunks so that they didn't get that month-to-month stuff. As there was relatively little greenhouse gas for most of our history, the temperature fluctuated but essentially remained the same for most of that time. But looking from 1971 to 2020, their model shows warming at an increased speed. It's gonna get warmer faster, changing the Earth in unpredictable ways that we have never seen before. 2014 was the hottest year on record, beating 2010, which trounced 2005, which had previously won over 1998, and then 2013, 2003, 2002, 2006, 2009, 2007, and 2004, respectively. That is the top 10 hottest years since we started checking in 1880. Notice they were all pretty recent. In fact, 2014 was the 38th year in a row with anomalously high global temperatures. According to the US National Climatic Data Center, part of NOAA, if you're under 30, you have never lived through a year where the average surface temperature for our planet was below average. People who are 60 have had a completely different Earth than we have in terms of the climate. The oceans were at different temperatures, the weather was less severe, and the extremes were more tempered because those things hadn't changed. Not to be outdone, 2015 has already been a big year for climate change. A study in Science Advances from NASA and Cornell outlined a timeline for the coming megadrought. Using models built from observing climate trends, their study says that we have an 80% chance of experiencing a drought worse than anything we've seen in North America since the 12th and 13th centuries. Humans can act to decrease the chances of the mega drought, but man-made global effects are exacerbating the drought already gripping the American West. Not to mention these crazy snows. The Northeast has had record snowfalls this year. As the globe warms, snowfall increases. We can all remember a bad storm or a hotter summer, but luckily, data doesn't rely on the terrible human memory. The US Global Change Research Program does a national climate assessment every year, and they found a 71% increase in very heavy northeastern storms from 1958 to 2012. It's not just storms, though. A study in Geophysical Research Letters found that volcanoes will increase as Icelandic ice melts, increasing surface heat and further spewing greenhouse gases into the atmosphere. Climate change, y'all! From November 2012 to December 2013, over 9,000 authors published over 2,200 papers, and only one disputed man-made global warming. One. And that author blamed the sun, which is hot. That is true. But while the sun has been consistently tossing energy at us, the levels of CO2 in the atmosphere in 2013 were 142% higher than 100 years before. So we need to face it. The climate has already changed. Scientists believe that it is possible to curtail the effects of man-made global warming, but you already knew that. Now we have to decide what to do about it. Why don't you tell us what you think down in the comments? I'm sure you've already started. Make sure you subscribe for more DNews as well. Pollution and climate changes were something ancient people never had to deal with. But drugs? It's a whole different story. Our sister show, Seeker, looks into the hallucinogenic habits of ancient humans and those of tribes that survived to tell us about those habits still today.
The consumption of ayahuasca, a powerful plant hallucinogen. The plant affects the visual centers of the brain and produces visions of geometric shapes and patterns that they later manifest in their work.
Check it out. Make sure you subscribe to their channel as well. And thank you for watching DNews.